What's up, queens? Happy Friday. Welcome to another episode of Totally Inspired. And if you're new to this channel, please make sure you subscribe, like, comment, and share. Like I always say, you never know who this message is going to touch. And to the returning subscriber, the inspired community, thank you for your love, your appreciation, and all the comments that you keep sending, the likes. I see them, keep them coming. Well, today is June 25, 2021, and the world is celebrating World Vitiligo Day. World Vitiligo Day was first celebrated in 2011 and has since become a global event with the purpose of raising awareness and recognition of the bullying, social neglect, psychological trauma, and disability of the millions of people affected by vitiligo. This date was chosen in memory of pop icon Michael Jackson, who suffered from this rare skin disease until his death, which occurred on June 25, 2009. Vitiligo affects anybody, regardless of age, gender, or ethnicity. It occurs due to lack of melanin, loss of pigment, creating pale white patches on the skin. Almost 1 to 2% of the population across the globe is suffering from this rare condition. Vitiligo is often met with misconceptions, so to create awareness amongst people, World Vitiligo Day is observed annually on June 25. You may ask what the causes of vitiligo are. Well, vitiligo occurs when pigment-producing cells, melanocytes, die or stop producing melanin, the pigment that gives your skin, hair, and eyes color. The involved patches of skin become lighter or white. The symptoms of vitiligo are categorized on the basis of segmentation. Firstly, there's segmental vitiligo, also known as localized vitiligo. It affects only one area of the body and is generally found in children. This disease is less common as compared to non-segmental vitiligo. The second one is the non-segmental vitiligo. It can appear on both sides of the body as symmetrical white patches. It can affect arms, elbows, back of hands, knees, the skin around the body openings, and various other areas. When it comes to treatment, well, there is no cure for vitiligo. There are a variety of treatments available, however. One of the most advanced treatment options is UV light therapy, which is overseen by a doctor but can be self-administered easily at home using a portable, easy-to-handle device. Most common medical treatments include medicated creams and ointments for skin, oral medicines, medicine and phototherapy as a combined treatment, surgical treatments like skin grafts and tattooing small areas of the skin, also sunscreens, and of course, counseling and support. Well, there are some very, very popular people out there that actually suffer from this condition. One of them is Winnie Harlow. Winnie Harlow is undoubtedly the modern face of vitiligo. The young model has chosen to embrace her spots and is a public spokesperson for vitiligo too. The Canadian model was a finalist on America's Next Top Model and went on to secure a contract with Desigual, all while appearing in campaigns for Sprite and Swarovski. She also walked in the 2018 Victoria's Secret fashion show. Vitiligo is just another difference, said Hello. Like freckles, big hair, tiny ears, everyone has differences. Another queen who has this condition is award-winning actress Leleti Khumalo, who capsulated to fame as a teenager in Sarafina. She is no stranger to the public eye, but since ditching her attempts to disguise her skin condition, Leleti is attracting even more attention for all the right reasons. I first noticed light spots on my upper leg when I was about 18, Leleti recalls. They weren't painful and they didn't bother me, so I simply shrugged them off. When she fell pregnant with triplets, her doctor told her the pregnancy might cause her vitiligo patches to spread even further. She unfortunately lost one of the triplets soon after birth. I credit my husband with helping me come to terms with vitiligo, she explains. At the height of my grief and sadness, I asked him if he felt differently about me because I looked so different. He said I was still as beautiful to him as I was the first day he saw me. So many people with vitiligo are belittled, humiliated, and mocked because of their pigmentation, said Leleti. I want to send people the message that this disease doesn't change who you are as a person. Living successfully with vitiligo means embracing and accepting who you are without any shame. Well, I do hope you have found this very educational and informative, and that today you will join me in celebrating these beautiful, beautiful queens. And above all, the lesson here is let us embrace ourselves for who we are. Well, until next time, queens, please do keep inspiring. God bless. So there you have it, queens. Hope you had been inspired by today's video and that you'll go out and be more and do more because you deserve a full life. Before you go, remember, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of this inspiring content, and do share my link with your circle of queens. Until next time, keep inspiring.